Ed Chester here for Trusted Reviews, and we're looking at the Toshiba Folio 100, their 10-inch Android-powered tablet. First impressions? It's quite large, even larger than the iPad, and of course much larger than the Samsung Tab, the big rival that's arrived yesterday. Not quite the same level of build quality. It's kind of a bit more plasticky. Sort of bezel around the screen here that's not quite as slick as other devices. Also, screen viewing angles not quite as impressive as the best out there. It's a 1024 by 600 resolution LCD, so it's plenty big enough in that regard and fit plenty on screen. Just back to the hardware. Features-wise, no camera on the back, but a 1.3 megapixel megapixel webcam on the front there. Connectivity here: we've got full-size HDMI, full-size USB, and mini USB, as well as full-size SD. So perfectly set up for connecting all your bits and bobs without having to use smaller cards like micro SD and that sort of thing. Lock switch on the top there, and the dock connector on the bottom that, like the Samsung Tab, is not just a normal USB but also allows you to stream your video through it. Looking in a bit more detail at the software side of things, Toshiba's given Android a sort of bit of a makeover, a bit of a skin here. So it's got this kind of custom interface here. Go between these tabs here and add widgets to the desktop, bookmarks, various websites, and the settings. The usual sort of thing here. Not the best custom thing we've come across. It's a bit slow. It makes the whole device feel a little slow. It's using a 1 gig ARM processor, I believe, like most of these tablets. So it should be nippy, but it feels a bit sluggish. Otherwise, it's standard Android, if we can get back out of this. So you've got your web browser. Again, don't know if you can see that through the video, but slightly sluggish looking. No multi-touch, or at least no pinch to zoom. So you've got to resort to, when it pops up, the zoom buttons. Haven't looked yet at Flash video. Give it a go. Wi-Fi here and here, around here is so slow, this probably isn't the best bet, so we might just move on from that. But yeah, otherwise, standard Android, all the usual features you'd expect. Interesting device. It's a very low price, which is going to be something that's going to obviously tempt a lot of people. Only £329. Going to be available come officially sort of October, but we've heard that actually it'll be hitting shops more like November. So, if that interests you, only a couple of months to wait.